Over the weekend, at a drag queen story hour at a library in Sparks, Nevada, the Proud Boys showed up to do a little protest claiming that these drag performers are somehow grooming children. They're sitting there reading them books. Something that these kids may not get at home. Something that brings joy to these kids to sit and listen to these stories being read by a performer, okay? Drag is a performance. These are essentially actors and actresses that do this. They're putting on an act. But, as I said, the Proud Boys showed up, did a counter-protest. The police were there for a while, monitoring, as they said, from a distance. You know, don't want to get too close to the Proud Boys, because they might think you're one of them. And then the entire thing went completely off the rails when one of the Proud Boys pulled out a gun and started approaching the library. At that point, according to the reports, the children, the performer, the parents, everybody panicked, screamed, and ran into the library for safety, because this event, of course, was taking place outside. And they think the drag performer is the one that's going to somehow corrupt our kids. The Proud Boy approached with a weapon drawn, as the reports say. It wasn't in his holster. It wasn't just on his person. The weapon was drawn. No shots were fired, thank God. But this is what we're doing to kids. This is what's going to mess them up for the rest of their lives. Events like this, not because of the drag performer, not because they had drag queen story hour, but because of these ridiculous gun fetishists who think that the solution to any problem in their lives is to just pull out a gun and do whatever the hell they want. These children thought they were going to die. The performer thought they were going to die. The parents thought they might die, thought they might lose their kids because of the actions of these Proud Boys. And of course, by the time the gun was pulled, the cops had already gone. The cops had already decided, oh, I guess there's no real issue here, so we can just go on home. And of course, after that happened, once the Proud Boys knew nobody was looking over their shoulders, that's when they pulled the gun. There is a sickness in this country, but it is not coming from transgender individuals. It's not coming from the drag community. It's not coming anywhere from the LGBTQ community. The sickness is coming from people like the Proud Boys. The sickness is coming from the Republican Party itself. A party that has spent weeks upon weeks upon weeks telling us that drag queens are somehow terrible for children and that they're going to pass legislation to ban children from drag shows. But you can still take your kids to Hooters and get pictures with the nice little servers there. Oh, we just don't want the drag queens to be grooming them. But it's okay for them to go to these places that over-sexualize women. There's a sickness, and that's about all I can describe it as. But that sickness is originating from the Republican Party, and they're trying to push it on all of the rest of us. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.